He's up at dawn every day. He has so much to do. With his job, he'll never stop. He'll always eat good too. That's Alan, Alan of the Allagash. That's Alan of the Allagash. Sunfish are his cash. He sleeps in the woods at night. He lets the water all day. He's always right on the little side. He doesn't have much to say. That's Alan, Alan of the Allagash. That's Alan of the Allagash. Sunfish are his cash. He gets a dawn every day. He has so much to do. With his job, he'll never start. He'll always eat good too. That's Alan, Alan of the Allagash. That's Alan of the Allagash. Sunfish are his cash.
I'm coming.
Jumping Jay Hossifer, there's Alan. How you been, boy?
Fine, Bill, just fine. How's business?
Well, I haven't had time to comb my whiskers. Them flatlanders been coming by here 2-3 times a week. They ain't like the old days when a fella could have a little peace and tranquility. Why, it's like a heatwave running by here now. Hold on while I fire up the grill. Boy, I ain't seen you for 6 months. Not since you caught that monster, Sonny. Boy, that was a whopper. They're still talking about that upstream. What's the big celebration? How come you having a fancy store-bought breakfast? Catch another hog, Sonny?
Nah, Bill, it's my birthday today, and I always like to make it kinda special.
Crazy kid celebrating getting older. When a man gets my age, he knows not to hoot about. Well, we's all fired up. What do you have, the deluxe special?
Ah, no sense being crazy. Just the usual, please.
Eggs and bacon coming up.
You sure got yourself a fine view here, Bill. That sure smells powerful good.
Best thing, breakfast on the gash. Here you go.
Thanks, Bill.
you. God darn it, Alan, Frenchie wouldn't be here if it weren't for you. Why, that means your polecat got the first nickel he ever got, and he stole that. Sure as a black fly to get a piece of your hide in me. He'll try to weasel something out of us.
Aren't you being just a little bit hard on Frenchie?
You'll see, darn it, you'll see.
Please, mon ami, a cup of the soothing coffee to end my misery.
You got any money, polecat?
Bill, I am choking. Please, mon ami.
It's okay, Bill. Put it on my tab.
No good whistle.
Ah, as I have always said, mon ami, you are the true gentleman. Alan, Bill, my news is sad. The old man, Franklin Fairservice, is dead. He had no family, and if you could only lend me the $95, I could rent the old man's camp from the paper company, and I could pay you back with the interest.
I'm sorry, Frenchie. My pappy always said, loaning money is like a man trying to go upstream with only one oar. He ain't gonna make much heading, and he stands to lose quite a bit. And somehow, Pappy's words always seem to ring true.
Well, I gotta get going now. Big day ahead. Thanks for the meal, Bill. See ya, Frenchie.
Take your weasel friend, would ya?
Bill! You were such a funny man.
No good, polecat.
Sure flies. Happy birthday to you, and may the next year bring you nothing but smooth waters and hog sunnies.
Thanks, Mike. How are you about this year?
All right, except for this damn arthritis. Don't ever get old, Alan. There ain't no future in it. Anything special today?
Not just the usual, please.
Six pack and a can of lard coming up.
Where's the old Philco, Mike? I hear it, but I don't see it.
That ain't the old Philco. I got me a TV.
Go on, you ain't got no electricity.
I wouldn't lie to you, Alan. I got me a TV that runs off batteries.
Wow, that's the first TV I ever seen. Ain't that a beauty? Why, it's just like watching radio.
Yep, I got it from some fool flatlander. I hear they're selling TVs for $400 today. I traded my 10-horse Merc. That'd be worth about $200 for this.
Boozy's new strain jack and sick. Pumpkin smashing is not a victimless crime.
And now you can too.
Today we're coming to you from the Boston Museum of Fine Arts, where we're speaking with curator Bertie Howard.
Phineas, today we're going to view our abstract art wing, where we have the Neoplasmodic exhibition.
Yep, that's PBS. That's Phineas J. Carbuncle. He can learn you a lot.
How's business been this year, mind you?
I wouldn't be able to make ends meet if it weren't for repeat customers like you.
Well, you know, if I had two birthdays a year, I'd spend the second one here, too.
Hot damn, Alan. You don't need a birthday to come in for a six-pack.
There ain't no good reason for a man to drink more than a six-pack a year. My pappy always said, without moderation, a man's on the road to damnation. And somehow, pappy's words always seem to ring true.
It's all right, I can fix it. You just gotta hit it here.
Well, just about time for them hogs to start hitting. Best be shoving off.
Good luck to you, Alan.
See you next year, Mike. Pappy? I got a fine mess of hogs for you today, Jeff. First, you might as well get rid of this trash bag. Yeah, ain't that a wicked mess of them?
I got some bad news for you, Alan. Plant's closing down. Today is the last day that we're taking in sunnies.
What you talking about closing down? What the hell am I gonna do now? All I know is fishing sunnies. My pappy learned me and his pappy learned him.
Now calm down, calm down. It's not my fault the company's been bought by some big conglomerate and they're closing the fertilizer plant and putting up one for natural gas.
What you talking about, natural gas?
You know, bottled gas.
You mean tell me people's buying bottled fat?
No, you hick. You know when you row out into the shallows and stick your oar in the muck? Them bubbles that comes up, that's natural gas.
Damn fool flatlanders. Paying money for that when they can just go stick an oar in the muck.
Now, Alan, I got this cousin, Cousin Biff. He's a foreman down at the Big Widget Machine Shop in Boston. I want you to go down there and tell him I sent you. And he'll give you a job. But, Alan, no matter what he asks, if you'd done before, you'd tell him you'd done it. Somehow, things always seem to work out best that way. I'd be going down there myself if my brother didn't have the American chop suey and small engine repair down in Milo.
I guess there's nothing else I can do.
You better head down tomorrow. It's the Big Widget Machine Company in Boston.
How do I get there?
You just go down to Herbis Landing, take the path up to the dirt road, and follow it south till you get to the main highway. You ought to be able to hitch a ride. You got any money, Alan?
Well, I got $13 saved and the $2.67 you give me. That makes it over $15.
That only gonna last you a couple months. I hear things cost wicked down south.
Well, I'd best be shoving off. I'm going to go to Big City tomorrow.
You be careful not to get run over. I hear they got a powerful lot of cars in that city.
Why, I seen cars before. I ain't no heck. Heck, I even seen TV.
I better set clock hour early if I'm going Big City tomorrow. I just don't know what I'm gonna say to Pappy.
I don't know how to tell you this, Pappy, but I gotta leave the gash for a while. But I'll be back someday. I'm gonna miss you, Pappy.
Neighbor, where are you going?
I'm headed for Boston. Get me a job in the Big Widget Machine Shop.
You're in luck. That's just where I'm headed. We can go all the way in.
This looks like it must be Boston. Is this Boston? Are we in Boston now?
No, heck no. Now we won't be to Boston for hours.
This place here is mighty big. Is this Boston? Are we in Boston now?
No, Boston is really big, but we won't be there for hours.
Look at that there! Is this Boston? Are we in Boston now?
Hey, relax. Just sit back in your seat and enjoy the ride. I told you we won't be to Boston for hours.
Wow, do you see that? Is this Boston? Are we in Boston now?
Look, buddy, you're trying my patience. I'll tell you when we get there. I've told you we won't be to Boston for hours.
Why, I've never seen anything like this before in my life. We must be in Boston. Is this Boston? Are we in Boston now?
All right, that's it. We are not going to Boston.
Get the hell out of my car.
To Boston, get me a job in the big widget machine shop.
Come on in. Back in. I know where you go. I'll give you a ride. Come on.
You want me to pick up them cans, mister? I'd sure like it a lot better, mister, if you'll keep her on a steady head.
Say that! You just see me as a big old man.
I think you had too many today, too.
Whoa, what's that? Fly! I hate flies!
I think you'll give me right just about far enough, mister. See me a shortcut. Looks like he must have been someone wicked important. Looks like I must be just about there. It sure looks like a wicked big city.
Thank you.
That big widget machine shop must be around here somewhere.
Hey guys, look at this guy in the rubber boots!
You tell me how to get to the big widget machine shop?
Hey, there's something wrong with that. He's weird. Don't say anything.
Excuse me, can you tell me how to get to the big widget machine shop? By Jiminy, Jeb should have warned me these Flatlanders are a mite uppity. Machine shop?
How dare you say widget to a nasty old dame like me?
Hey, you with the boots! Stop in the name of law!
He's gone now. There's nothing we can do.
I don't know as if I'll ever find that big widget machine shop.
The big widget machine shop? I can tell you how to get there.
You just go down to this next set of lights and take a right. It's the third building on the left. You can't miss it.
Thanks, mister. You must be about the smartest man in this whole city. Say, didn't I see you on the TV?
That's right. I'm Phineas Carbuncle. You've probably seen me on PBS.
Well, I best be shoving off. I'm gonna get me a job in that shop. Thanks again, Mr. Carbuncle.
Can I help you?
Jeff sent me down from the Allagash. Said his cousin Biff give me a job here.
Cousin Jeff, the hick? Sent you? Well, all right, have a seat. You just fill out this application for me?
There ain't no call for riding up on the gash.
Well, here, I'll give you a hand. Need your name?
Alan.
I need your last name, too.
My pappy always said, ain't no sense in one person having two names. And somehow, pappy's words always seem to ring true.
Okay, what's your address?
I sleep in the woods at night.
Oh, another Daniel Boone, huh? I need to know three people you've known for at least a year for personal references.
Well, there's Musker Cook Mike, Bill from Bill's Bluegill Grill, and Frenchie Bouton.
I suppose they all live on the Allagash?
Yeah.
Okay, Bill must be the cook. What's Frenchie do?
He's a skunk scent collector.
Okay, now, what school did you go to?
My pappy learned me all I need to know.
I know this is a stupid question, but have you ever run a Matsura before?
Now, well, and this is important. No matter what he asks if you've done before, you tell him you've done it. Somehow, things always seem to work out best that way.
Yeah, I done it.
Wow, that's great. Have you ever programmed one?
Yeah, I done it.
Oh, that's just fantastic. I suppose you want to start today.
Sure. I'll
take you over to your machine. Thank you.
the hell you think you're doing? This is the worst piece of junk I ever saw. Clock by over 10,000. Knuckles, throw this bum out.
I ain't never gonna say I done it before again.
No, you hick. You know when you go out into the shallows and stick your oar in the muck? Well, them bubbles that comes up, that's natural gas.
I ain't never leaving the gash again.
Calm down, Pappy. We got work to do.
That looks like them bubbles those flatlanders like. I'll just give her a good one.
Alan, you in there?
Dylan?
Jeb, is that you there? Why, I ain't never seen you before in a Flatlander halter.
Oh, you gotta wear it when you're with Happy Gas. What do you got there?
I've got you a powerful load of gas here.
That's gas, all right. I got a tester here somewhere. Let me put this butt down.
I don't know why you like puffing on them.
Oh, that's gas, all right. We don't even have to test it. Why, you got more gas there than the company gas boat. Where'd you get all that gas?
I found me a wicked good spot to farm it.
I guess you did. Here you go, $95.
Why, that's more money than I used to make in a year.
I'm making good money, too. They said they'd pay me twice as much as my brother was able to, just to wear this preacher suit and lug around gas. And if I did real well, they were going to raise my salary up to minimum wage. You know, those big conglomerates, they're not so bad after all.
Why, ain't this wicked? Why, I got me enough to rent Old Man Fair Services.
You want me to drop that money off at the big paper company for you when I haul my gas up to town?
That'd be mighty fine of you, Jeb. I'm gonna shove off now and catch me a mess of sunnies. Take them over to my new house. Why, I might even have me a beer or two.
I'll be seeing you when you bring in your next load.
That won't be for a while, Jeb. You don't want to over-farm a good field. Frenchy, but I'm back for good. I'm renting Old Man Fair Services.
Ellen! I must have the word with you!
Ah! The aroma of the frying sunny is like a kiss from the gods.
Well, have a seat then, Frenchy. That's plenty here.
As I have always said, mon ami, you are the true gentleman.
Alan, now that you have the big house, I feel so bad. You will have to live in a big empty house with nobody around.
Maybe I should move in with you. Then I think you would not be so lonely.
I don't think so, Frenchy. My pappy always said, quickest way to turn friend to foe is to share a roof with him. And somehow, pappy's words always seem to ring true.
But Alan! You will feel so lonely, and I will feel so sad. It is not right.
Maybe you're right, Frenchy. You should live with me in my big house. I think $5 a month rent to live in such a fine house is a fair price.
But Alan, I could not think of going against the words of your blessed deceased pair. May his soul rest in peace. We do ourselves well to honor one so wise. I think I should visit you. Then I think you would not be so lonely. Tell me, Alan, did you not like the big city?
I'll tell you, Frenchy.
They're all buzzing around that hive like bees on a swarm, all trying to get some fancy doodad or another. When they get that, they seen some other doodad they have to have. My pappy always said, you can't always get what you want, but you can want what you get. And somehow, Pappy's words always seem to ring true.